Welcome everyone, one and all, to day number 8 of Retro Gaming Month. And what's this? Another game by Konami? Back whenever they were really, really, really good at making side-scrolling games. Say hello to a showcase video of the adventures of Batman and Robin. Or Batman ampersand Robin. Sure, why not? We can roll with that. Now, this game, as you can see, was released in 1994 for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System, or SNES, for those of you who just want to call it that. It's a really, really, really fun side-scrolling game, and if you can ever get your hands on it, I would really recommend that you do. I had to buy my copy from eBay, and it was right at about the $30 to $40 range, and yeah, that's probably going to be the last game that I buy for that high of a price, just to legitimately do, you know, recording a game for Retro Gaming Month on the actual console. You see, that's how dedicated I am to this month. I actually spend a lot of money on old game systems, and old games no less, to play on them. Because emulating just isn't the same for this month, and as you can see, I'm not even starting this, by the way. This is just the game playing itself, and there's no background music. I'm tired of that. I want background music. So I guess I'll just stop talking. For those of you who have not seen the animated series as of yet, stop watching this video right now. Go to your local Best Buy or wherever the hell you can buy DVDs at and buy the seasons. Now, stop watching, go do that. And then come back upon watching a few episodes, and then you can continue watching this and fully appreciate the game. Wow, Bruce looked really pissed. Whenever I was a kid growing up, you know, by the time that I had really started watching TV with a conscious mind, the series had already ended officially. And they were just playing, you know, the repeat episodes. But I still remember watching them whenever I was a kid after I got off of school. I almost said off of work. But whenever I was a kid and I got out of school and I went over to my grandmother's house, like in the late afternoon, I would actually watch this, X-Men Evolution, Justice League Unlimited. And I remember Batman Beyond whenever it was on Kids WB and not Cartoon Network. So I really mainly watched Batman Beyond Saturday mornings. As for the other three shows that I mentioned, for the most part I watched those on Cartoon Network, even though X-Men Evolution was also on Kids WB. I vaguely remember watching that one on there though. But anyways, yeah, I'm done reminiscing. And yes, Alfred, it is a trap. Congratulations, you have officially become Admiral Akbar, only better. And wow, Bruce changes into his Batman outfit pretty quickly. Oh, jeez. Prepare the equipment! Yeah, if you ever read the subtitles that they have for them, instead of, you know, the voice acting, which is just a bunch of beeps or boops, you'll notice how they did not proofread this, because there are a lot of missing spaces. Like, there's a space missing between a comma and another word, and it's really weird how it just does that. But beyond that, this game is flawless. So, as you can see, your equipment is, you have a batarang, a grappling gun, and here are your sub-weapons. The star, spray gun, smoke bomb, plastic explosive. These aren't particularly useful during this part of the game, you know, during the first stage. And then you have these little side gadgets right here, the gas mask, flashlight, and x-ray goggles. You don't need these for this stage in particular. In fact, I don't really even need any of these, so I'm just gonna go with the batarang and the grapple gun. There aren't really any benefits to bringing them with you, I believe, on this stage anyways. There you go. Eat Thug! Actually, I kind of find it pretty hilarious how all of these enemies that you fight on this stage are the stereotypical mobster-looking guys that have the fedora and the blazer and everything. They go down pretty easily. Are you showing off your skills there, bro? The game is broken. He's just punching in the air, just Check out my punch. That's so silly. I'm pretty sure you just shot your friend in the back of the face. That's wonderful. Stop shooting your friend. That's terrible. Okay. Yeah, they go down in two hits, unless if you jump and drop kick. Or grab and throw, that works too. Okay, seriously, how did you punch me? The hit detection was weird on that one. There you go. I thought you wanted to go into the amusement park too, buddy. That's why I threw you there, but it looks like you hit the ground too hard with your face and you passed out.
Whoops!
Look at this, we get our own welcoming committee. Harley Quinn. And also look at that, they have Joker's face carved into there. Like it's an actual 3D carving out of stone or concrete or whatever. That is amazing. You hear that? Did you hear that Joker statue? You know, well, not statue, but did you hear the Joker machine gun statue laughing, right? That is how fun this place is. It already introduces laughter. And, well, it looks to me as though we're kind of stuck. Well, whatever will we do? Well, just wall jump as such. There we go. I was kind of hitting the D-pad in the wrong way. Forgive me, viewers, but I have not played this game in about a year. I've never once been crushed by that, and I probably never will. Note to self, there are spikes there. Jump next time. Oh no, we're stuck again. We can't quite wall jump because, well, we'll just jump into the spikes. This is where the grappling hook comes in handy. Bazam! That is pretty much all you need to do. And also for that little tidbit right there. Damn it, Steve! Stop jumping into spikes! What did I just say? Wow, I died on the spikes. I died by jumping on spikes. I am setting the bar even lower than what it has been placed before. Let me try that again. That was absolutely terrible for a showcase video. I apologize that you had to sit through and watch that. Okay, there we go. I don't want to get shot at by the Joker statue. I'm sorry, viewers, but the D-pad on my controller is kind of being somewhat unresponsive. That's probably a bad thing, seeing as how, well, I don't really have the money to buy. Damn it! I thought that I was past that. Seeing as how I don't have the money to really buy another one. Steve, what did I just tell you about jumping onto spikes? I said don't do that, and you did that anyways. You don't get dessert. I didn't want dessert anyways, it's okay. Here we go, we have a sub-boss right here, which is just a gigantic statue toy soldier thing that just walks back and forth and jabs. And every single time you kick it in the face, or hit it in the face in general, sparks fly up. And yeah, if those sparks hit you, well, as you can see, they deal a little bit of damage. Not too much, but still, I prefer not to get hit. Ah, fuzzy hell. Well, the good news is I didn't die again. Yet. We'll get to that here in a second, though. Congratulations, Batman. It's like playing Find Waldo. And no, you're asking Joker to surrender quietly. Really? You're asking Joker, of all people, surrender quietly? How long have you been chasing Joker? How many years? Yeah. That was a stupid question, Bruce. You know, he's just standing there long enough for Batman to just suddenly come in and just, like, dropkick his ass off of the roller coaster. Oh, well, whatever. Storyline! Maybe Batman had to go pee really badly and he's taking care of that right now, and then he'll go get Joker. Harley was waving goodbye to Joker. Isn't that adorable? Hey, look, is that a penny? Oh my god! It was worth it, viewers, because I got a penny out of it. Did you get a penny? Didn't think so. Okay, let's try this little tidbit again. This time, with full health. And hopefully no failing. I can't believe I died on spikes. The showcase video is already terrible. Although I was serious, if you have not already watched the animated series, do it now. It's great. Twin Terrors! I'd rather not get hit by any of these, which of course it had to happen twice. Three times! Where if I get hit a fourth time, I'm going to be one unhappy kitty. I'm not a cat. Oh, and by the way, for this tidbit, I actually remember this one. You want to stay ducking. Because if you get hit... Okay, let me rephrase that. If you get hit by one of those light fixtures that are just, you know, floating there, it will deal a lot of damage to you. Ow, my face. Batman, stop trying to catch bombs with your teeth. I know that you're badass enough, but you don't have to prove that you're even more badass. I don't like this part because you have to be precise with your punches, otherwise that happens. Stop it. I don't want your bombs! These are terrible Christmas gifts. Here, I'm re-gifted, son of a bitch. I said a dirty word. I'm sorry. You know what, I'm just gonna hit Y repeatedly until I punch them all back at him. Oh wow, that last bomb kind of fell. I hope that didn't hit little Timmy in the face, which I'm pretty sure it did. Alright, this part, let's jump and not fall to our imminent deaths. You know, that's kind of a terrible roller coaster right there, you know, that last little bit actually falls to their death. I mean, I know that thrills are one thing, but I mean, come on, seriously? Ow, no, I don't want your bomb, stop it. Why are you laughing at me? That's mean. Stop that. It's kind of cheap how the game just sort of throws that, you know, whole entire ducking moment into the game. While you're trying to fight Joker, no less. And by the way, the game goes away from being a whole entire, you know, like side-scrolling game to suddenly becoming a fighter because you don't turn away from your opponent. You're always facing him, no matter what. I think it's during every single boss fight. And by the way, you might want to get really used to the controls because I remember that it's like the final stage of the game. It's just one big boss rush mode and it is hard as hell. Stop pointing at my dick and laughing. Batman, what are you doing? Are you high or something? You let him get away. You just clearly let him point at your junk, laugh, and just jump off the roller coaster. I'm done with you, Bats. I'm sorry. But you just flat out let him point his finger at your crotch, laugh at the size of it, and then just make his getaway by jumping off. Jeez, I've ruined this game for me already. I'm sorry. Anyways, this has been another showcase video done by yours truly, Air Pirate Sid, and I will see you all tomorrow with another showcase video, hopefully one of which I will not fail at horribly. I still can't believe I fucking died on spikes. The shame. I brought great dishonor to my family.